as we see, the race is a big tourism draw card, but at the moment, those who govern the industry are in upheaval. The government has axed the CEO of Tourism SA. And with more on that, here's our political reporter, Adam Todd.
That's right, Alan. Ian Darbyshire told to pack up his desk immediately. Now, his axing is the culmination of months of scandal surrounding the Tourism Commission. Now, the Tourism Minister, Gail Gago, held a bizarre press conference today, insisting his axing had nothing to do with his performance, arguing the Tourism Commission needed to restructure. But she couldn't explain why Mr Darbyshire couldn't oversee those changes. Now, she also argued it was a cost-saving measure, but Mr Darbyshire still has a year to run on his contract and will receive a hefty payout. Now, he'll be replaced by a part-time CEO overseeing an industry worth $4.5 billion to the state.
South Australia's tourism debacle has claimed its first scalp.
And we'll move on. I just want to move on. Find something else to do.
Mr Darbyshire heading home to family after his employment was terminated this morning.
There's no point in having bitterness. It's a wasted piece of energy.
The former CEO disappointed but unrepentant amid scandals including the failed travel centre privatisation and a taxpayer bailout for the Kangaroo Island Surf Music Festival.
I don't think anything has gone wrong at SATC.
He sadly has been the scapegoat for the minister's poor performance.
Just yesterday, Gail Gago described Mr Darbyshire
in glowing terms.
Today, she was struggling to outline why he'd been axed.
I can absolutely assure you that this change has nothing to do with his performance.
She reverted instead to jargon.
We need to bring about structural reform. As I said, we require a flattening of the organisation. We need to improve leveraging across the agency.
A restructure that's going to end up with a flatter structure that nobody actually knows what she's talking about.
Mr Darbyshire will receive a golden handshake of at least $250,000. Adam Todd, 10 News.